What's going on, everybody? Glad to be back with you. Hey, this is it. I'm back. I miss you guys, man. You know, as all I can say is that I miss you guys. Welcome back to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. Hey, this is January 1st, and what can I say? Happy New Year to you. Actually, it's about like maybe 6:30 in the morning, so, you know, hey, I'm just letting you guys know that I'm just getting up, I'm ready to go, I'm fired up. Hey, I hope you guys had a great holiday. I'm glad that, you know, everybody's okay and everything, and, you know, I'm just so excited to be back to, you know, talk to you guys. You know, this episode of the Guru Talking Sports Podcast is basically the year in review. And what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at, you know, what happened in 2022. But before that, I want to go and I want to make sure that I get you guys caught up on some of the things that happened, you know, in the last, you know, couple weeks that I wasn't on the air. But, hey, man, what's going on? You know, hey, we got a brand new thing that we're going to do. We got a lot of good new stuff that we're trying out. And like I said, we didn't have the intro in the beginning. What I'm going to do to you is tell you right now, I'm coming from the Black Goat 39 Studios, the home of Black Goat Sports. And now, you know, I just want to let you guys know that this is the Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 147. There's going to be a lot of new stuff this year. We're going to try out a lot of new stuff. And believe me, we try out things that's going to fit. So, you know, hey, kind of like out with the old, in with the new. So, you know, I just want to let you guys know that I'm really, really glad to be back with you. Really, 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 really excited about the new things. And welcome to 2023. How about this one? What we see in 23 should be very good to me. I guess. I don't know. I'm trying to rap a little bit. You know, I actually had episodes where I had a little bit of rapping on it, but I know a couple people have asked me to bring back some rapping, and I think I will try to do some rapping this year. I was going to do something before Christmas, and you know, you know, it's just been really, really, really busy, you know, busy with the job and everything and, you know, getting everything ready for Christmas and all and, you know, dealing with the things I had to deal with and all like that. But, you know, I'm just, you know, just really, really glad to be back in studio, ready to hold the microphone and, you know, break down what's going on in sports and everything. And, you know, I know that there's a lot of stuff that went on while we were gone. You know, I was actually supposed to do the Christmas show because, you know, that damn fool, the Guru Claus, never showed up. You know, I'm not sure where he at. I don't know where he could be. You know, he was, you know, telling me that, you know, he's going to come down. You know, I don't know if he's, you know, got his, you know, flight or sled mixed up or whatever. But, you know, you can't really depend on, you know, certain people. And believe me, you got to make it happen for yourself because the thing is that no one else is going to make it happen for you. You got to do it on your own sometimes. And it's always good to have help. But, you know, you got to remember that when it comes down to it, the chips fall where they fall. You know, you got to make sure that you have got to be able to answer the call whenever it's time. So I just want to say, you know, in that regard, hey, I don't know where that Guru Claus is. I don't know where that damn fool is at all. All right, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to reverse the program a little bit today. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to start off with some news and notes. We're going to talk about a couple things that happened over the couple of, you know, weeks that we've been gone. You know, I know there's been a lot of, you know, talk about the Immaculate Reception, Franco Harris, Barbara Walters, and, Pope Benedict. It's a lot of stuff. But you know what? I'm going to try to get you guys caught up on all that stuff. And then what I'm going to do is, I know it's sports and it's actually, reality too. And I want to let you guys know that, I watched a lot of stuff. Saw a lot of things that was going on. And, I just definitely want to comment on them. I definitely want to comment on the college football playoff that went on last night. And believe me, there was two amazing games. Unfortunately, my boys from Ohio State fell. But you know what? I think we gained a little bit of respect in the way we played. Because, for 2 weeks, a whole month or so, everybody was talking about why they should be there. And, personally, I thought that they shouldn't belong there. And I'm being honest. I'm gonna come to you straight. I'm gonna come to you realistically and let you guys know that, hey, look, I didn't feel as though that Ohio State needed to play in that game. But you know what? They proved to me that they should have been there. Even in the loss, I saw something from Ryan Day that I, didn't see in the last game against Michigan. And now it's four straight losses now that, Ohio State hasn't been to the, been to the championship in 2020 when they lost to Alabama. But you know what? Now is the loss to Georgia in the semifinal, the loss to Alabama in the 2000 final, two losses to Clemson in the semifinals. And now it seems as though that everyone's going to be focusing on those losses. I'm not going to focus on those losses. I'm going to focus on what happened last night and basically move on. And, I got to say something for Michigan as well. I'm going to be realistically honest with you. I'm not a Michigan fan at all. But you know what? They showed me something last night. They showed me something. Some of the things that they did, little mistakes, the targeting, that stuff happened. But you know what? I gained a little bit of respect for Michigan. But TCU surprised me. Surprisingly good. And believe me, I don't have a problem with saying that TCU might take this whole thing off. Sonny Dykes did a great job this year. And basically, TCU and Georgia in the final coming up in a week from Monday. So, I'm not going to be mad at Ohio State for the way they played. They showed me something. And I was the one that was the biggest critic of them being there. I said, well, hell, why don't you just go to the Rose Bowl and call it a day? No, they came back, they fought with heart and fought with dignity, and they lost. But hey, you know what? I'd rather see my team go down swinging than to just basically lay down and go down. Yeah, that rhymes, lay down and go down. Yeah. All right, so tell you what, there's a lot of stuff that we're going to get to. A lot of stuff that I've been, trying to, compile together to make sure that I bring you 2022, the recap of 2022, give you the stuff that's going on for 2023, and give you stuff that, update of what was going on in the 2 weeks I've been off the microphone. So you guys, look, I'm going to tell you what, I'm going to take a break right quick. I'll be back in a few minutes, but you're listening to episode 147 of the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. And yes, believe me, there's something special headed for episode 150. I tell you what, this is what I'm going to do. Let's go to the break. Voice actress lady is here. and let us go to the voice actress lady and take our first break.
You're listening to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast.
Welcome back to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. This is episode 147. And like I said, if you can hear some enthusiasm and some pep in my tone of voice right now, it's only because I had 2 weeks off, and I'm actually on vacation now from my work. And work has been good. Been doing the same thing, driving, and you know, there was a couple times where I might have had to go up to Boston area and enjoy it. And like I said, you know, work is not a job for me. It's basically relaxation. You know, I get in the truck and I remember when just getting the opportunity to do what I can do, you know, to prove myself that I can, I belong. And I really enjoy it. And it makes for a, you know, it gives you an eye opener. And it makes for, you know, just remembering some of the good things that has taken place. And like I said, this is it's very, very, you know, very nice to be back on the microphone and talk to you and let you guys know that, you know, I really appreciate, you know, just, you know, things and everything. I just really, really appreciate everything. You know, I'm just, you know, sometimes, you know, my words, they don't come out all the way right, or sometimes it's just that I talk in general. But, you know, I really enjoy just being here. I really enjoy just spending the time with you, getting the stuff off of my mind and into my mouth and into the microphone is three different things. But I enjoy it, to say the least. Okay, so I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to do news and notes. And, you know, I want to, you know, just not, you know, dwell on the fact that Ohio State isn't playing for the, you know, the championship this year. But like I said, I just, you know, Marvin Harrison Jr., I just hope that he comes back. I really do hope that he comes back. You know, the way he went out and, you know, got hit in the end zone, and, you know, he basically, you know, was, you know, injured, and they took the helmet away from him and said, this is it, this is your night. You know, I didn't have a feeling of, uh-oh, we're going to lose. I had a feeling of, you know what, I think they're still going to be able to compete. And they did. They went down swinging. You know, and that's one thing you could say, is that when you go down, you always want to go down swinging. You know, and like us, you know, Michigan looked, I mean, hey, they were in a battle. They were in a battle. And believe me, they earned my respect. You know, and like I was telling my buddy Rob, you know, hey, you can't hold your head down because they are the Big Ten champs. Just remember, they beat Ohio State to earn the second, you know, earn the second seed in the playoff. You're not a chump, or you're not a pushover when you earn that second seed. You're a pretty damn good football team. And, you know, we don't know what, you know, status is with Harbaugh, whatever. I don't know. But you know what? I look at it this way because, you know, like I said, I really don't follow their program. I know some of their players, you know, and, you know, we'll see some of their, you know, senior players or so going into the draft. But you shouldn't hang your, I told Rob, you shouldn't hang your head because that team, it didn't work out the way it had to. You know, they wanted to. But they shouldn't be able to hang their head because they were a great football team. You know, like I said, you just don't earn, you know, just don't get the second seed. You're the Big Ten champs. And I sit here and I talk about Michigan, Ohio State. You know, I'm the biggest Ohio State fan there is. But you know what? I look at it this way too. And I told this to Rob. Conference first. I'm looking at it for the conference. I just wish that Ohio State could have won. Yeah, it would have been nice. But you know what? It's conference first. Big Ten conference first. And, tell you the truth, I really haven't looked at a whole lot of the bowl games only because I've been really focusing on what's going on with Ohio State. And, you know, I haven't really looked at them. But I can say this, that, you know, I just wish that, wish the Big Ten a whole lot of luck, except for Penn State. I like Utah. Utah's going to win that game in the Rose Bowl, which is coming up tomorrow. And guess what? I'll be home tomorrow to watch the Rose Bowl. And like I said, I never try to miss the Rose Bowl because that is my favorite game of all the college games. I love the Rose Bowl. You know, I've been to the Rose Bowl game one time, and I saw Penn State beat Oregon, and, you know, I had a great time there. But like I said, I just wish that Ohio State was there when I got a chance to see them. All right, so, you know, other things are going on. I don't know if you've been paying attention to basketball, but hey, my Brooklyn Nets look good, don't they? I got to say one thing about the Lakers. What I seen from LeBron the other night on his birthday, really, really nice, 47 points. And they won. Who knew? Actually, the Lakers won the other night. So, you know, basketball has been going on. You know, hockey has been going on. And, other things been going on. And like I said, you know, I'm going to be getting up here talking about the NFL picks in a few. But, you know, I look at it this way. Hey, them Nets look good, man. They look good. You know, they won again last night. And, you know, I'm happy. You know, I'm pretty content with the Nets right now, even though a lot of, you know, people been throwing salt on them. And, you know, it's self-inflicted, yes. The Nets have been a hot mess for a little bit. You know, at the beginning of the season, nobody wanted to play. Fire the coach, fire the GM, I don't want to play. Kyrie and his stupid self. You know, I'm not going to go into all that with Kyrie. Because, you know what, he hit that game-winning shot, you know, a couple weeks back. And, I ain't got no issue with it. As long as he can just keep his flat-minded thoughts to himself, he's okay by me. So, you know, they won last night. 123-106 over Charlotte. I'm sorry, Charlotte. You know, but like I said, I just really am excited about the Nets. And I can watch the Nets now for the next week or so because I'm on vacation. So I'm going to chill out. I'm going to be relaxing. And like I said, you know, got a full slate of NFL games coming up here a little bit later. Got college football tomorrow. You know, Rose Bowl tomorrow. So, you know, it's going to be pretty decent. Now, like I was telling you before that I'm a conference guy. Now, I do see a couple teams from the Big Ten that's playing in bowl games here coming up tomorrow. Mississippi State still mourning the loss of Mike Leach is going to play Illinois. I'm going to go with Michigan. Mississippi State, only because, you know, like I said, I am, you know, a Mike Leach fan, and I'm going to be rooting for them, and more. They're going to be mourning their loss, you know, and I'm going to be with them in mourning that loss. Illinois, I know, is a pretty good team. Brett Bielema did a great job with them, but I have to, you know, pay my respects to the Mississippi State football program. LSU is going up against Purdue, and that's tomorrow, like 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And wait a minute, if they're going up 1 o'clock in the afternoon, that means that General Hospital might not be on. But I, you know what? I'll catch General Hospital on the ABC app, and you know, check it out then. USC and Tulane is going to play tomorrow. No big deal on that game. Like I said, I'm going to be rooting for Utah to beat Penn State. I don't like Penn State, so. And like I said, the big game is next Monday, the 9th, when you got TCU playing Georgia and in Los Angeles. That's going to be a very good game. I like TCU. From what I've seen in TCU, Georgia is pretty tough, and I got to give respect to the champion. You know, you can't beat a champion if you don't beat the champion. Georgia's a champ, and I just feel as though that they showed a lot of holes yesterday. And believe me, their secondary is not that good. Their secondary is not that good, but they got strong linebackers, and they got a big defensive line. So, like I said, we'll see what happens. But, you know, I'm not salty. I'm not upset. They played their best. Ohio State played their best. So, you know, let's move forward. All right. Let's see. Like I said, news and notes and everything, you know. Just, you know, that's basically it for news and notes. And like I said, Lakers have been playing pretty good. They're still like 14 and 22 or something like that. And, you know, hopefully they can still stink it up so I can win that bet. And actually, I won the bet on both Michigan and Ohio State yesterday. But, like I said, we got to see what happens a little bit later on today in these NFL games. And, you know, like, it was kind of weird. Yeah, last week, you know, Saturday was Christmas Eve. You had football games on Christmas Eve. You know, you had football games on Sunday. I really didn't watch a whole lot of the football games on Sunday. I watched a lot of the games on, you know, that Saturday, Christmas Eve. And I had to go out with Ms. Guru and Mom Guru. And they, you know, basically drug me out there. And we had a great time, you know, had dinner. Oh, and I got sick on Christmas morning or Christmas afternoon. And ended up having to, you know, not watch most of the stuff I wanted to watch. So anyway, I'm okay. Feeling a lot better now and doing okay. So, all right. So, poo-poo of the week. Let's go to poo-poo of the week. Now, I watched this team and I seen their downfall. And hopefully they can continue to downfall and be a, you know, big poo-poo in their pants like they usually are. The Tennessee Titans was a poo-poo of the week for the last couple of weeks for what they've been doing. How can you have drafted one of these guys out of college, out of Liberty, Malik Willis, and you don't start him? You start Josh Dobbs, who have not started a game or whatever. You know, rest all your players thinking that you're going to be ready for Jacksonville. But guess what? I think Jacksonville's going to beat their mess. beat the mess out of them. Beat them down. That's what I want. And hopefully Jacksonville can do what they supposed to do today, because guess what? They're facing a Houston team that's beating them 9 straight times. 9 straight times ain't cool, but you know what? Jacksonville, you know what you got to do. Trevor Lawrence has been playing out of his mind. And believe me, I like the way Trevor Lawrence has been playing. I never had doubts about Trevor Lawrence. Everybody else has. I just said, hey, you know what? You know, last year, I didn't even want to mention that, you know, there's certain people that are, you know, not relevant to me. And I don't even mention their names. Especially the Cleveland quarterback and the former Ohio State quarterback or coach. I don't mention their names. They're irrelevant to me. They don't exist to me. So, Trevor Lawrence had to grow up, and I think he's grown up and came into his own, and hopefully he could put Tennessee out. And you know, the thing is with Tennessee, they had all these guys that they sat and they're going to rest, and they think that they're going to, you know, oh, well, you know, we'll come in, be ready. Hey, in Jacksonville, hopefully my boys, the Jaguars, can be ready to take them down. All right, so poo-poo of the week, that's them. You know, they are basically the poo-poo of the month, the way they've been playing. Believe it or not, January 1st, man. Gosh, man, I can't believe it. Time flying. Now, next thing you know, it's like, hey, you know, it'll be April or March Madness. Then April, baseball season. Then next thing you know, we turn around, fantasy football, football draft, and all that stuff. Oh, I do have to mention that the team in my league went down, and I got to congratulate the rookie. Came in, won the championship in his first year. Team Bauer, Hunter Bauer, my man. He won it. Got to congratulate him, give him props. Hey, he did his thing. So, you know, congratulations to Team Bauer for winning the third and long Fantasy Football League Championship. I came in fourth, which is not bad. You know, like I said, I don't have to win a league. I don't have to win a league. I don't have to justify myself by winning the league. And, you know, I feel as though that if everyone in the league can be competitive, I can be competitive to give you some competition to step your game up. Hey, I can do it. I don't have to win. I don't have to win. Matter of fact, I want, you know, everybody to know that I did. They have me as the champion of 2020. Now, I'm explaining this to you. I'm the champion of 2020 only because we didn't have a league that year. And the trophy has to stay in-house somewhere, right? So it stays in the house here, and that is the league trophy. I am the league, and basically I won the league trophy. So, all right. So I tell you what, I got a few things that's what's, you know, pissing me off. Yes, what's pissing you off is next. And I want to say this. The one thing that's been pissing me off is that people that come to me and ask me my opinion on politics. I don't have an opinion on politics. And like I said, I'm not going to get into this because this is a sports podcast. Do not ask me anything about politics. I will plead the fifth. I will not answer you. And I feel as though that it's not my business to talk politics. You know, I just don't like being put on the spot by talking politics. Because, you know, so your thoughts on what you feel is your thoughts. my thoughts on theory on what I feel about politics is my thoughts and theory. We don't have to agree. You don't have to worry about it, because guess what? I don't want to know your thoughts and theories on politics. That's one of the things that's been pissing me off. Now, I'm going to say this, and, you know, in this household, there is difference of opinion on politics, and it doesn't work most of the time. But the thing about it is that my thoughts and my beliefs are my thoughts and beliefs. Her thoughts and beliefs are her thoughts and beliefs. And yes, I don't agree with some of it, but I don't want to hear it. Really don't want to hear it. That's one of the things that's been pissing me off. All right. Another thing that was pissing me off was that bad service. Bad service during the Christmas time was very rampant. And believe me, I don't go out and shop in the malls and everything like I used to. I usually order stuff on Amazon, and like I told you before, I get a lot of stuff. And, you know, Christmas is not the same for me. It might be, you know, different for you, different for everybody, but this is Christmas for me. As long as, you know, Ms. Guru do her thing, she's okay. You know, I go along with it. You know, everything is all good. Me, Christmas ain't about me. I don't really need anything, because guess what? I buy stuff for myself all year round. Now, this year, I'm going to curve it a little bit. I'm going to curve the spending on myself for, you know, obvious reasons. I just don't want to, you know, keep spending money on myself and spending money on myself and spending money on myself again. But the thing about it is that, you know, that's why I do kind of do that, because Christmas is supposed to be just remembrance of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, okay? But the thing is that I noticed that, you know, I had to go into a store, and I thought that, you know, Ray Guru sent something to a store, and I go into the store, show them my information. Next thing you know, they act like they don't know what's going on. The girl asked me about 7 times, what's the number? I show her the number, you know, and I understand that everybody's busy during Christmas time, but the thing is that if you don't have the product that Ray Guru is sending me, get with it. I mean, show, you know, be a little enthusiastic about it. You know, I worked in customer service during Christmas time. Believe me, I worked for Foot Locker years and years and years ago. I know how it is. You know, and, you know, it's busy. You know, but Foot Locker is not the store in question. Matter of fact, I'm not going to, you know, mention the store. But I remember that, you know, that Christmas grind was a Christmas grind. You know, everybody, you know, trying to get those high, you know, quotas and beating the day and all that stuff. But the thing about it is that you remember, you got a service to do. You have got to be customer ready and be able to help those customers. Customer service sucks right about now. Believe me, it does. It really sucks. So I still haven't got the information, or they haven't sent me any information to Ray to give to me so I can pick this up. And, you know, we're a week now away from Christmas. So, I don't know. I just, like I said, customer service is another thing that's pissing me off. Other than, you know, crazy drivers, and my truck broke down a couple days before Christmas, and I've been running a rental truck, but you know, that was kind of like messed up. That kind of pissed me off, because guess what? Now I'm in a rental truck. I'm in, you know, working the rental truck, and my truck is still sitting in, you know, being repaired. And now I'm, you know, on vacation. So I'm just, you know, kind of, you know, I want to get back into my truck. You know, that's the thing. I feel comfortable in my truck, you know. But I meant to tell you this. I got this this really, really cool thing. It's called a little espresso machine. So it's like a handheld coffee maker, and which is cool because you can put the coffee in, put the hot water in, and you know, you pump it, and next thing you know, you have hot coffee. You know, I really like that. But the thing is that the truck I got now, I can't use it. You know, because I don't have any hot water in there. I don't have anything. My microwave is in my other truck. So I have to heat up the water, a little bit of the water, to put it inside to make the hot coffee. So that's kind of, hopefully by the time I go back to work, my truck will be ready. Okay, so I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take another break, and then let's go to the second half. And oh, definitely. I tell you what, this is what we're going to do. We're going to take a break. We're going to come back. We're going to do the NFL picks, and then we're going to go to the second half. I knew it was something. Guru's mind is, you know, get to wandering and thinking, and guess what? It goes like that. So anyway, all right, so we'll be right back with the Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 147. Voice actress lady will take us into the next break, and I'll be right back with the NFL picks. Take it away, voice actress lady.
You're listening to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 147. And I meant to mention this that, I was telling you a lot of things have been pushed back. Tomorrow, the Winter Classic, the Penguins at Fenway Park to take on the Boston Bruins. I'm definitely going to watch that. I love the Winter Classic. But it feels weird not to have it on New Year's Day, because usually there was, you can watch the Winter Classic really early in the afternoon. And then, like I said, you know, there's a couple other bowl games on, you know, Fiesta Bowl and, you know, all the other, you know, bowl games that really didn't, it was kind of like irrelevant to me. But, you know, the thing is that the big bowl I usually watch, and like I said, I love, is the Rose Bowl. You know, and like I said, I usually would plop in a chair for all those hours and watch, you know, hockey in the morning, a little bit of basketball or whatever, and then maybe, you know, Rose Bowl game. But, you know, like I said, all this stuff has been pushed back because today is Sunday, and, you know, NFL is, you know, king like it is usually, and that NFL slate is coming down today. Now, like I said, mentioned, next week there will be some flex games, and I'm just hoping that they can flex that Jacksonville game to Saturday, or, you know, maybe the late Sunday night window. But then again, if it's the late Sunday night window, I might not be able to watch it because I might have to be on the road or so. I have to take a check and, you know, see what's going on. But anyway, now let's get to the NFL picks of the week. And I want to mention that these games are coming down to it. Also, before I go into that, I want to mention that I am in another fantasy football league. And I'm currently going for my third straight title in this league. Just wish me luck, and hopefully I can pull it out. But my man DeAndre Hopkins might be out today. So I've been trying to scramble around to see if I can find another replacement. Unfortunately, I don't think that, my wide receivers are been pretty good. They haven't been really, really strong. But the thing about it is that it really hurt me when Breece Hall went down. And I've been starting Latavius Murray. And, you know, it's kind of like a hit or miss because I don't know what Denver, whatever Denver is going to do, you know. And like I said, you know, 2 weeks ago, I had to watch a lot of football games and watch a lot of stuff. But believe me, I got some things that I want to say about, you know, these teams here coming up. So anyway, what I wanted to mention is this. It's fantasy championship time. And believe me, I have actually been pretty, you know, like I said, I'm a competitor. I am a competitor. I usually don't have to win the league that I'm in, but the league that, you know, I play in where I'm not, you know, the commissioner, I'm going to try to whoop your butt every single time. You know, that is my thing. I am going to try to, you know, put my foot on your neck and try to keep it there and try to keep moving. Now, I'm not saying that in a negative, disrespectful or trying to be, whatever it is. But, you know, I have to do what I can do to win. And like I said, the waiver wire has been very, very good to me. And I basically used the waiver wire as much as I could. So what I'm going to do is cue up the sounder for the NFL picks. And here we go. Hopefully this one is it. Let's see. Nah, that's not it. All right. I know. I'm the board op today. I'm the board engineer. Kane Guru is not here. Kane Guru is, he's at home. He's chilling. He's probably asleep right about now. Like I said, it's about 7:30 in the morning. So anyway, let me cue up the right one and let's go to the NFL picks of the week. Hit it, voice actress lady.
And now it's time for Guru's Picks of the Week.
Thank you, voice actress lady. I really appreciate you. And doing a great job. All right, NFL Picks of the Week. Let's say, we don't have any sponsors, so I can't say sponsored by. But anyway, I went to BetMGM. I use two apps, BetMGM and I use Caesars. This time it's actually BetMGM, and I have the NFL picks of the week right here, right now, and let's get to it. Okay. First off, Arizona is a 6-point underdog. They're going into Atlanta to play the Atlanta Falcons, and believe me, I'm not sure what's going on with their quarterback situation, but I know that Kyler Murray is out for the season. And Arizona has been stinky. J.J. Watt just announced his retirement. And good luck to you, J.J. I'm sorry you have to endure this, but I'm going to go with Atlanta and take the 6 points. Okay. Right along here, Chicago is going into Detroit. Detroit has been playing pretty good. Now, what if we see Jacksonville and Detroit make the playoffs? That would be pretty good because, you know, out with the old, in with the new. And I kind of like Detroit in this game. Chicago has basically given up, and I think what it is now that, you know, they're looking forward to the next season. So I'm definitely going to go with Detroit in this game. And I'm laying the 6 points. Kansas City and Denver. Well, you know, I had a feeling that Denver was going to be that bad this year. And they did find Nathaniel Can't Hack It. So, Kansas City is a 12.5 or 12.5 favorite. And definitely, they shouldn't have any problems. This should be a tune-up game for them for the remainder, you know, for the next couple weeks or so. They got to play the Raiders next week. And I don't even want to mention the Raiders and what they've been doing. So, you know, that Kansas City, that division, the AFC West was supposed to be the bad division where, you know, you got all these teams are going, you know, even I said that all the teams in the AFC West will make the playoffs. I'm not wrong, but the Guru's never wrong. He's always right. You know, bust the facts. Guru's always right. So anyway, you know, I kind of misstepped on that one. I misstepped into something on that one. So, all right. Miami is going into New England to play New England. And New England is a 2.5 point favorite in this game. Now, I'm in a dilemma. I'm trying to figure out if I should start Mike White or Mike White, who is back, or should I start Teddy Bridgewater in this game. Teddy Bridgewater will get the start for Miami, so I'm going to go with Miami in this game. They should break that losing streak that they've been on and get themselves back into the playoff conversation. Matter of fact, wild card conversation, because I don't think they're going to win the division. Buffalo is probably going to wrap that thing up pretty soon. I'll talk about Buffalo in a little bit. Okay, Indianapolis. What can I say about Indianapolis? Everything that happens in Indianapolis is worth it. You know, one of the things, and they are actually a poo-poo of the week. I actually never thought that I would see the day where I would just really, really hate the Colts as much as I do. You know, Rob Irsay is talking about now hiring Jeff Saturday as their permanent coach. Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. Ignore the Rooney Rule. You know, it just shows, goes to show that, you know, and I'm not calling out the race card or anything in here. It's not, no race card here. But the thing about it is that teams are supposed to go by the Rooney Rule, you know. They're not doing it. They don't want to do it. So, you know, any bad luck that they have earned. No, they deserve. Like I said, I don't like to say that word deserve. You only deserve an ass kicking. And believe me, the Giants, get yourself together, win this game, and you'll be in the playoffs. Having a 33-point lead and losing to Minnesota the way you did. Oh my gosh. It was so enlightening to see. So, on that note, I'm going to say, go ahead, New York Giants. Kick their ass and win that game. Go to the playoffs for the first time in maybe 11 years or so. So, I'm going with the Giants and I'm taking a 5.5 points on that one. Philadelphia. Well, can't win them all, can you, Philly? Oh, but I didn't say anything when Dallas beat y'all. I didn't say anything. Because you know the first thing that comes out of Philadelphia fan, oh, you're a hater. You don't like us. You hate us. No, I don't hate you guys. It's just I'm realistic. You guys know you wasn't going to go, 16-1? Come on now. Be realistic. Live with it. Live with it. You lost. Live with it. So, saying that, I'm going to say that Philadelphia will go back on the you know, back on their winning ways. They will beat New Orleans. And yes, I'm picking you again, Philadelphia. So don't call me and say, hey, you hate us. No, I don't hate y'all. I don't care, really care about you guys. I got other teams I worry about. I'm taking Philadelphia, and I don't think they're going to win by 9 points. But I'm taking Philadelphia. They beat New Orleans today. They can wrap up the number one overall seed in Philadelphia. All roads lead to Philadelphia. And, you know, what happens when, you know, last time they had the overall seed when they had, they were playing and Tampa Bay came to town. Oh, we ain't gonna mention that, right? They could have went to Super Bowl, but no. Anyway, I'm not gonna get into it with you guys, Philadelphia. And like I said, it's a brand new year, and y'all ain't gonna get me. I'm not falling for your foolishness. You know, Philadelphia, you will win this game today, but believe me, I got some thoughts for the future. And you guys. Alright, so Carolina is going into Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay, I don't know. Brady can still rally on this thing, but, you know, Carolina's been playing pretty good. Chuba Hubbard's been playing good. Steve Wilks looks like he might keep that job. But, you know, never know what's going to happen. Tampa Bay, I'm going to take the 4 points and go with Tampa Bay. Now, the next game on the docket is Cleveland is going into Washington to play the Commandos, and Carson Wentz is going to start. I don't like Carson Wentz. I don't like him because I think he's a prima donna, and I think he's a crybaby. I'm going to go with Cleveland in the up, and I'm taking the Cleveland Browns to win, and I need Nick Chubb to go off. He should be happy because the Georgia Bulldogs won. So I'm going to go with Nick Chubb to win. Hopefully help me win my fantasy league in my other league. Championship in my other league. Like I said, it's pretty early, so, you know. Give me a second here. And like I said, it's very, very early. It's about almost like 7:45 in the morning. And I still haven't got this podcast finished. I know I have to have it out before 12 o'clock, which I am going to have it out before 12 o'clock. All right. Excuse me, I had to take a swig of coffee. Coffee in the morning. Usually have tea, but coffee this time. Jacksonville is a 3-point favorite over Houston. It's simple. Win this game. Go next week for all the marbles in the AFC South. Jacksonville has lost 9 straight games to these guys. And believe me, they won last week. Houston won last week. Who did they beat? Tennessee. Another proven fact that they are poo-poo of the week material. Alright, get it done. And hopefully we won't have to worry about, you know, we'll worry about Tennessee next week. I'm taking Jacksonville. And I think that if they can score over 24 points, they should be okay. Hopefully they can beat them. But like I said, Houston, you know, showed some fight. Lovie Smith, I saw him last week. He looked pretty good. They showed some fight, and they did win for their second time, you know, for the second time this season. So, I'm going with that. All right, that's the games in the 1 o'clock window. The 4 o'clock window is simple. You got, excuse me, I'm fumbling here. My pen is like falling over. All right, so you got San Francisco in the 4 o'clock window plays the Las Vegas Raiders, and the Raiders will have a new quarterback under center, Jarrett Stidham. Jarrett Stidham is taking over for the next 2 weeks. It's been really, really bad for the Raiders. I don't see them winning this game. San Francisco is a 9.5-point favorite. I hate to do it, but San Francisco is probably one of the best teams, and not just NFC. They're probably one of the best teams in the league. And with Christian McCaffrey, he's going to probably run all over them. And I wish I had him on my fantasy league, and whatever. So, Like I said, Derek Carr is not in the building. He was sent home, and I guess they mutually agreed that his time in Las Vegas might be over. And believe me, I am just very disappointed with the way the season went for the Raiders. I picked them to go to the playoffs, and that's not going to happen. They should have won that game last week, the 50th anniversary of the Macklin reception, but they didn't win that game. So, anyway, got to go with San Francisco and lay in the 9.5 points. The Jets are in Seattle to play Seattle. This has been a pretty, very, very big game. And believe me, I definitely, think that Seattle can pull this game out. I don't know. The Jets are really tough. Mike White is back. And just like they said, Derek Carr home. They sent, Wilson home. Zach Wilson home. Because he looked like a pure turd on that, Thursday night game. And believe me, I didn't think that Zach Wilson was the, choice anyway. I like Mike White. And like I said, I actually picked up Mike White. And one of my fantasy, on my fantasy team that's going for the championship. And I think I might roll with Mike White. See how it goes. The Jets are a 1.5 favorite. And I might have to roll with Mike White. My choices are Teddy Bridgewater or Mike White. I don't know. If you have any things that you, can think of or let me know, just let me know. Anyway. All right. So I'm going with, I'm going with the Jets in this one. I think the Jets can win this game, but Seattle's tough at home. It's going to be very, very tough atmosphere. I'm going with Seattle. I said the Jets, but I'm going with Seattle at home. Green Bay and Minnesota. Green Bay and Minnesota. And guess what? Minnesota's an underdog again. I don't understand why, but line makers, they see something in Minnesota that we don't. And they, for the second straight week, they done picked Minnesota to lose this game. And like I said earlier, when they picked Detroit to beat them, I don't know. It's going to be tough. But you know what? I'm going to go with Minnesota in this game. Green Bay has to have a good game from Romeo Doubs, and they have to have a the other wide receiver. You know what I'm talking about. Anyway, he should have a good game with him. And Green Bay is a 3-point favorite, but I don't think that this is going to matter because Minnesota's the cardiac kids. What I see from them coming back from that 33-point deficit and winning that game against the Colts made me a believer in them. And, they shouldn't be in the situations that they're in. They should be a lot, it shouldn't be that close. But the thing about it is that Minnesota has shown me something. They have the heart. Kirk Cousins, K.J. Wright, Jefferson. It's a good team. They just like to play from behind, I guess. So, all right, we'll get, I'll take Minnesota in that game. The Rams and the Chargers. The Rams looked like they were world beaters last week, didn't they? Putting 51 points up on the board, making that other team look terrible. Chargers, I like them. I'm actually rolling with their defense. So I'm going to take the Chargers in this game. You know how I feel about Baker Mayfield. I'm not a big fan. So we're going to go with the Chargers. I got two more games. I'm going to wrap this up and take a break here. But I got the Pittsburgh and Baltimore. That is a 8 o'clock game. And I still think that Baltimore maybe be able to pull this out, but you never know. We're not sure what's going on with Lamar Jackson, but I'm definitely, you know, some of their defensive guys are coming back. Calais Campbell should be back in this game and all. So I'm definitely going to go with my hometown Baltimore Ravens and taking the 2.5 points. Now, Monday night, like I said, I'm on vacation, which is pretty good. I know I keep reminding you guys I'm on vacation, winter vacation. Monday night is going to be a very, very good game. Buffalo is a 1-point favorite going into Cincinnati. And this might be one of the best NFL Monday night games of all times. This one here is basically two teams that have a lot of wins. This is like the third or the fourth time I heard on Monday Night Football that this has happened. So I'm going to definitely go with, I hate to say this, but I got to go with Buffalo. I got to go with Buffalo. I want Joe Burrow to do good because he's my quarterback in that fantasy league. So I definitely want Buffalo to do really, I want Cincinnati to do good, Joe Burrow to do good, but I think Buffalo is going to pull this one out. So I'm going to go with Buffalo on that game. All right, so we got Atlanta, Detroit, Kansas City, Miami, the Giants, Philadelphia, Tampa Bay, Cleveland, Jacksonville, San Francisco, New York Jets, psych. I'm going with Seattle, Minnesota, the Chargers, Baltimore, and Buffalo. So hopefully I can win this championship, and hopefully I can get this done. Because like I said, it would be nice that, you know, the first couple years I was in this league, I was getting my butt kicked. You know, I think 1 year I was 3-11, something like that. They played 14 games. Then next thing you know, I was like, you know, 5-9 or something like that. So, you know, next thing you know, I was turning around 11-4, 11-3 or something like that. And then 10-4, I think 10-4 this year. But anyway, I'm hopefully I can get that third elusive championship. I've never won 3 championships back-to-back, and hopefully I can do it this year. I'm really hopeful that I can do it this year. All right, I'll tell you what. We'll take a break, and we'll come back, and we'll go to the second half, and we'll talk about last year and, you know, wrap this thing up. But I'm like I said, I'm really, really glad that you can join me. Episode 147 of the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. I know, you know, I want to mention something. I said in episode 139 that I was going to do a simulcast of me where you can see me in the studio doing my thing while I'm out here talking. That's coming pretty soon. I'm not sure when, but it's coming pretty soon. So, all right, so let's go to the break and take it away, voice actress lady. We'll be right back with the second half, 2022, the year in review. Stick with me. We'll be right back.
You're listening to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast.
All right, welcome back to episode 147 of the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. Before I got back on here, I had to take a look at the list of celebrities and sports figures that we lost, and my goodness, this is a long, long list. And the people that we lost on there, I was surprised by a few that I didn't know about, and it's pretty long, pretty long. The obvious ones was Barbara Walters, who we just lost recently. Christy Alley. That was a shock to me. And like I said, I'm gonna go through some of these names. It's just so many that I think I wrote down about almost 150 names, and I don't know if I can get through all of them. But I'm gonna go through some of them, and then there's one passing that I'll have to talk about a little bit later. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go down this list and try to pick out. I'm, you know, my condolences go out to the families of everyone that we lost. And it was really, really a tough year. All right, here's some of the people that we lost last year. James Caan, Irene Cara, Coolio, Aaron Carter, Emilio Delgado. If you remember him, he was from Sesame Street. Queen Elizabeth II. Gallagher, Gilbert Godfrey, Estelle Harris. Remember, she played George Costanza's mom. Taylor Hawkins, Anne Heche, William Hurt, Leslie Jordan, Naomi Judd, Guy LaFleur, Angela Lansbury, Jerry Lee Lewis, Ray Liotta, Loretta Lynn, Bob McCrane. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing his name wrong. I think he was the one of the guys that were on Sesame Street as well. Christine McVie, Meatloaf, Olivia Newton-John, Nichelle Nichols. This one was a shock because I didn't know that he had passed. Louis Orr from Syracuse basketball. Sidney Poitier. Dwayne Haskins. Dan Reeves. Di Maynard. Clark Gillies. Bill Fitch. Charlie Taylor, who was on that Washington team that played Miami, the undefeated Miami team. Jeremy Giambi, me and him was Facebook friends. Katie Meyer, Ardalis Perez, Tommy Davis, Gene Hsu, Raphael Wright, John Drew, Wayne Cooper, Bob Lanier, Marion Barber, Hugh McElhaney, one of the original 49ers. Fred Ward. Madeline Albright. John Anson. That was the young lady from Friends, her father. Jennifer Anderson. Sally Kellerman. Peter Robbins. I'm sorry. Greg Robinson, Bobby Lydell, Jimmy Seals from Seals and Croft, Paul Serino, Takeoff, Howard Hessman, Madeline Albright, Clarence Gilliard Jr., he was in Die Hard, Sonia Eddy, she played Epiphany on General Hospital. That's why I remember. I saw that a couple weeks ago and I was shocked. Mike Bossy, Betty Davis. Betty Davis was the wife of Miles Davis. Tony Dow. Tony Dow was, he played Wally on Sesame Street. Joey DeFrancesco, jazz artist. Tony Saragusa, Dwight Smith. This one shocked me because Dwight Smith, I met him before. I talked to him. He was a baseball player. Played for the Cubs. And if I'm not sure, he probably played with Derek Lee, which is Dave May, or Derek May, which is Dave May's brother. And I'll have to check on that. Ernie Shavers. Maury Wills, Gavin Escobar, Vince Dooley, Fred Hickman, Mills Lane, Ronnie Hillman. Man. Lynn Dawson, Ray Guy, Bruce Sutter, Bill Russell, John Hadle, Gaylord Perry, Vin Scully, Mike Leach, Franco Harris, Pele, Roger Mosley, who was Magnum PI. I didn't realize that he had passed. Bernard Shaw and Tony Soraka. He played in a couple of movies like Goodfellas and all. My condolences to all the families and everything. And like I said, there was a couple people on this list that really kind of shocked me. Mikhail Gorbachev, former Soviet leader. I had to mention him as well. All right. There's one other person I'm going to have to talk about a little bit later. But for right now, I'll tell you what. Let's go to some good times. Let's go to some things that we have fun with on the podcast this year. And first of all, I want to give a shout out to Dave May Jr. Dave May Jr. has been on the podcast more than anyone, any guest I ever had on this podcast. And I want to thank him and his family for always finding the time. You know, I hate to bug him because he's always busy. And you know, the thing about me is this. When people are busy, I don't like to bother them. I like to schedule time when I can. And, you know, I always check with them to make sure that they have the time. You know, and Dave May, I got to give him a lot of credit because he's very, very, very generous. You know, I respect his time. I respect his time. He's a scout for the Toronto Blue Jays. And he basically is a, former Major League Baseball player. And he works hard, you know. And I definitely, you know, he might be compiling information, doing whatever, you know, stuff that he has to do. And I respect his time. And I really, really appreciate him coming on. And I thank you, Dave. And like I said, I chat with him. I'm going to probably chat with him a little bit later on today. Wish him a happy new year. And, you know, see when he can come back on. I know that he said that anytime before February, so I'm definitely going to have him on before, maybe for the playoffs, and we can sit back and talk a little bit. But I really appreciate his time, and the most tendered guest on the Guru Talking Sports podcast, and I really appreciate that. All right, so I had a few other guests on, and my cousin, James Davis came on. He's a Philadelphia Eagle fan. And like I said, Philadelphia Eagles, I don't hate you guys. I give you guys respect. Here's a little bit of his conversation with me and him. You know, chopping it up. He came on episode 134. Check this out.
And, you know, you got a lot of knowledge, man. And it's just that I had to sit back and just listen because, guess what? You had some great knowledge. And that was one of the things that, you know, it's good to hear when, you know, you bring someone on and they can basically steer the ship a little bit, you know. Like, I'm a Navy guy, so.
Anyway, I was talking to him and telling him that he was a great guest because he has a lot of knowledge. And my cousin James is a very, 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 very smart guy. And, very, very intelligent, and like I said, I like to get people on that, hey, I respect, and like I said, I respect the Eagles, and yeah, I had another Eagle fan on, and check this out, here's a conversation with my man, Darrell Amos, and he appeared on episode 133.
You know what? I think it's time to break this up. But yet and still, why would you when you can have a dynasty, you know? That's the thing. You can have a dynasty, but you don't want a dynasty. You would just want to just go ahead and break it up.
And that's right. I mean, that's why I think when it breaks for the dynasty, and no one think it was double up. And then the other team fight up together and fuck all that. Look, man, something's going to happen. He can't win. He can't win with Brady. I don't know. You know, because Brady even cut his salary to get other people on his team.
All right.
Actually, I was going to play the cut where he... Hold on a second.
So, I don't know.
All right, well, going to the next one. New Orleans, 2.5-point favorite over Carolina. I think Carolina's pretty much trash. I got New Orleans in this one.
Yeah.
Which dog is that?
That's my Jimmy Chuck.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's the big one.
Oh. Tell me he's on the podcast now.
Huh?
Tell me he's on the podcast. It's all good. It's all good. All right.
I like that part. Actually, I wanted to play that because that was pretty funny because me and him were sitting here having a conversation on the podcast and everything, and next thing you know, the dog starts barking. And one of the things I remember is that when you have a dog or an animal in the background, and sometimes you might hear Ellie or, you know, Alex in the background of this podcast, I usually just, you know, try to, you know, drown out their noise a little bit. But the thing about it is that, you know, with Daryl, we were sitting here talking, and next thing you know, the dog started barking, and I just went with it. I just rolled with it, and I was like, hey, tell the dog that he's on the podcast. He did pretty good. It was pretty funny. Me and Daryl go back a ways when we worked at the EE, and like I said, I just really, it was good to kick it up with him for a little bit. Here's another cut from episode 131, and this one was basically me and my man Dan, Dixieland Dan. He came on the podcast. Check this out.
What the hell? They probably won't even be on the list for in the next 16 weeks or so. So I'm gonna take my Jaguar. Who you got there?
Oh, good Lord, that's, you got two polished turds fighting one another. I mean, give me Jacksonville.
All right, there you go.
What's the point spread on it? What's the point spread?
Three points.
Yeah, give me Jacksonville. Hell, it's going to be more than that. One way or the other, somebody's going to burst out and the other one's going to lay down.
Two polished turds, that was a good one. Dante, what you got?
I'm taking Jacksonville.
That was the first episode of the when we kicked off the NFL season, and Dixieland Dan is a really, really good guy. One of my friends, he's a D alien from the DA show, and what I liked about that one is that he probably made one of the funniest statements on this podcast last year when he said Washington and Jacksonville, the first game of the season for both teams. He called both of them two polished turds. And I thought that was pretty funny. And I still use that today when I see two terrible teams play. Just like anything, it's just funny to find two polished turds, which is a really, really funny thing. The next cut I got is from one of the guys that I really, really enjoy and I really have a lot of respect for. He was going up against a field in the smack off. So what I had to do was I had to get this guy on. And I've been chasing him for the longest time. And really, really good guy, and I really appreciate him. This is Rick in Buffalo. Check this out.
And I went to Rome, Miami, and I gotta be honest, I was totally shocked by it. Yeah. I thought there was no way in hell that was gonna happen, and it happened. So that was 2017. So I was in 2018, 19, 20, and 21. So here, 2022 will be my fifth.
Okay. Now, I want to tell you right off the bat, I have you picked to win this Smack Off this year. Because, like I said, I know from listening to you from the first time up until now, you've always come through. You've always, you know, your calls are just tremendous. They're tremendous, and they are very, very skilled and well-spoken and well-read and well... You know, your participation is just awesome, man. I just want to tell you that.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. I take pride in calling pretty regularly. This past year, I haven't been able to get in as much. But during the football season, I got in quite a bit. I try to get in every month or so. This past year, I'm going to guess 7 or 8 calls, so not quite once a month. I think it's important for some of the regulars to call in more regularly.
Yeah.
And in the end, it might hurt me a little bit in the Smack Off because I'm not necessarily hoarding material. And I'm not going to call just to call. I wanted to make sure I have good stuff. So, you know, some callers hoard it, and that's fine. I mean, I just like to call. I don't care if it's the Smack Off or not. It's just fun for me to call.
And like I said, Rick in Buffalo is probably one of the best callers in the history of the Jim Rome Show. And like I said, I really, really appreciate Rick, man. The dude is really skilled. Really, really good. And I'm, you know, it didn't work out for him this year, but last year. But like I said, I think that he's gonna come through. And believe me, I've been riding, you know, the bandwagon of Rick in Buffalo, and I really feel as though that he's going to come through. So, I actually, like I said, I really appreciate everything that went on this year. I thought it was a pretty good growth year for myself, and I thought it was a good time in general for the podcast. When I first started this podcast, I never thought that it would take off as, you know, like it did. And like I said, like right now we are around at least, we're over maybe 100 or 200 countries across the world, including, like I said, I have a lot of people up in Canada that listen to me. I have a lot of people down in Mexico that listen to me. I've received letters, or actually not letters, emails and texts from people around the world. And I really appreciate the opportunity of bringing you my sports knowledge, which is not that much, but I just really, really enjoy coming on the microphone every single week and trying to entertain you and trying to make you guys laugh a little bit. You know, I'm, by nature, I think I am a pretty funny guy. I like to laugh, and I like to do sometimes crazy things, silly things. But, you know, that's just a part of not just being, you know, just trying to put on an act. You know, I am really that silly. I am sometimes really that absent-minded. You know, but as a guru, I'm a regular guy. You know, and like I said, if you don't know, you know, sometimes, you know, the guru is always right, which is a is normal, because it is true. The guru is always right. He calls it like he sees it. But, you know, like I wanted to let you guys know that I thank you all. You know, and like I said, there was a pretty long list that I read of people that we lost last year. You know, and hopefully that, you know, next year, by this time next year, January 1st again, we won't have to be reading a list that long. But, you know, when you go back to it, we lost someone this year in our family. The Guru Talking Sports Podcast family lost someone very, very special. And I wanted to talk about him right now. Cousin Aaron Ferrer, we lost him on May the 13th, 2022. Cousin Aaron was a great guy and a great mentor. I would actually get sports information, sports knowledge, and, you know, it's just like having an older brother sitting on the curb talking sports on the street corner. And it was a tremendous loss. I still feel the effects of him not being here. It's been very hard. There's been times where I've actually had to take a step back and basically think about the times that we spent together. You know, he was a mentor. He was a leader. He was an innovator in his own time. He basically created a Facebook page where he would put down his thoughts and his opinions. And I saw that, and I said to him, you know, we should hook up. We should hook up and do something sports-wise. You know, when you see talent, when you see people that are good, you want to gravitate to them. You know, Cousin Aaron, I always remember him as being a leader and a person that I can depend on when, if I didn't remember something or if I forgot something or just a little tad or something that he wanted to add in, I would always try to add in his stuff, because working together with him was a joy and an honor. And we lost him battling that terrible disease. I just wish that he was able to be here today to see the progress that we have created and the how we move forward on how we got this thing together. Every sense is passing, and I'm gonna try to not break down on this. You know, I'm kind of trying to keep it together. Every sense is passing. I set up a chair that sits right next to me, and you know, I feel his presence right here with me. It's been very, very difficult, to say the least, that we all, this family that I have, the Guru Talking Sports family, we have a we feel that loss. We feel that loss very, very much. And I want you to know that, Cousin Aaron, wherever you are, we love you. We miss you. And like I said before, in episode 114, this will never be the same. This will never be the same because what he has brought to this podcast was a sense of urgency and a sense of great sports knowledge to help me get through what I'm going through. Sometimes I feel like I'm a little bit lost. Sometimes I feel like I can't go on. But, you know, I know that if he was here, he would kick me in my ass and tell me to keep going. There's several times where I just wasn't feeling it. I hate to say that because, like I said, I try to come in every single time and give you the best. And I apologize if I didn't give you my best last year. But I will continue to give you my best this year because I know that's one thing that he will want it. Here's some of the cuts from the time that we spent together. Like I said, there are some of the cuts that you might have heard before. But this is paying tribute to one of our ancestors now that helped build what we have right here, right now.
We're definitely going to miss you here. This podcast will not be the same without you. But we always have clips of the memories of the good times that we have. And right now, I'm going to play a clip for you. Got two clips. I got a clip here from the first time he actually stepped up on a microphone as a co-host and a member of the Guru Talking Sports podcast. Now, I want you to know that, I did talk a little bit more, but, you know, I just wanted him to, say something. And this was a good moment. This was a funny moment because we went back and forth about the pay scale of Black Goat Entertainment, and he came out with a bang, and we really, really bonded together as a team. And like I said, after you listen to this clip, I'm going to talk a little bit, and then I got another clip for you as well. But I think what I'm going to do is take some time out to play back some of the clips that we had together and some of the times that we had together and let you guys know that, like I said, we will never forget Cousin Aaron, and we will always remember him, and he will always be a part of this podcast. No matter how it ends up or how it goes, we got something that we always going to have to definitely remember him by. He brought us a lot of good times, and a lot of good times means that we have the memories of his good times as well. So here's a clip from the beginning, Cousin Aaron on being on the program for the first time as a co-host. Now, we do have him a couple other times before. And I think the first time he actually came on was Super Bowl between Tampa Bay and Kansas City. I got to look that up, but I think that was the first time he had came on that I invited him on. But like I said, when I see greatness, I try to grab greatness. And here's the greatness of Cousin Aaron as we remember him. Here's a clip from his first time on. Here we go. Let me rewind this back. Rewind it back a little bit. Cousin Aaron, welcome Cousin Aaron to the Black Goat 39 Entertainment family, and welcome to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast.
Well, 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 thanks for having me, Guru, Guru.
Black Goat Entertainment will make sure that the checks will be out there. Ask Katie Guru when is he getting paid. And make sure that they are doing the good things that they do. Now,
that's great.
I want to say that I know that you're not obligated to come on every week. If you don't, whenever you want to come on, you're welcome to. This is your you are a part of the family now, and I want you to know that we really appreciate your participation, and we really appreciate your dedication to. This program, this podcast, I really appreciate you. Thank you.
Thanks for having me. Thanks for that. What you keep so long anyway? I'm full of jokes this morning.
Well, I tell you.
It's a pleasure.
Well, I tell you.
I feel happy being invited to your show. I've always wanted to come on and give you my 2 cents of work, if it's worth anything. But thank you for having me.
You know, the thing about it is that we had so much movement. We had so much changing of parts, and we're trying to make all the parts change, interchange into will we get the right formula. And I think that now, looking forward, we do have the right formula. Like I said, I have several people, several guests that I'm definitely going to bring in. And like I said, my man, I mention this all the time. Jeff Duarte is one of my closest friends, and he's actually the manager and editor of Cali Sports News. I'm going to get him in pretty soon. And I write for them. I haven't written in over a year because of the pandemic and plus the travel schedule. It's been really, really tough. I do want to mention before I go on that I am wearing right now a Ronald Acuna Braves jersey. Great Braves jersey. I love this jersey.
Now, this, like I said, it goes off a little bit, but I wanted to mention that, when we lose family members, we always want to take the time out to give them praise. And well, we have to praise them while we're here. And what I tried to do was give Cousin Aaron all the praise and all the credit that he earned. He earned a lot of credit. He earned a lot of praise. And we miss him every single day. Miss him a lot. I really, really miss him. I miss him because, like I said, he was like a brother and a mentor, and someone that we can basically talk to and I can always go to for sports information, general information, and just having a good having camaraderie with a good source. Rest in peace, Cousin Aaron, and we will always keep your memory here. And like I said, you know, when I need a joke or something like that, I'll listen to that podcast, that episode 114. And like I said, you can find all our episodes on YouTube. Matter of fact, all this goes on to YouTube as soon as I'm done. I edit it up and I make sure that everything gets written up and typed up and put in the right format. When you look at 2022, there was a lot of things that went on. We talked about all the things that went on, and like I said, you know, there was a lot. Brittany Griner getting captured over in Russia, being released. The Los Angeles Rams won the championship for the first time, bringing Los Angeles back another championship. The St. Peter's Peacocks was something that was a big thing. Coach K was a big thing. Roger Federer retiring. Serena Williams saying that she was going to retire. Georgia beating Alabama in the national championship. Argentina winning the championship, and Lionel Messi being crowned as the GOAT of all time. I still say Pele. Pele is, if you had to have a Mount Rushmore, you know, the three biggest superstars in soccer would probably be Pele, Maradona, and Lionel Messi. A lot of stuff that went on in 2022. And, you know, some unbelievable things and some unbelievable plays, like the the Jefferson catch, the game where Indianapolis dropped that 33-point lead on Minnesota. I mentioned that earlier. And, you know, that was something else, too. I quickly want to mention that, you know, we also lost Pope Benedict. We lost him a few days ago, just right before the end of the year. Rest in peace, Pope Benedict. Also want to mention that, I want you guys to know that, every episode we're going to try to do something. We're going to try to add something or try to put something on, but, you know, when we come on in the beginning, we're definitely going to, do it the right way. And like I said, I cannot have a podcast where, you know, things go wrong. And like I said, there was a lot of things that went on in 2022. I want to mention that, 2023 should be a better year. Correct a lot of things that went wrong. I mean, there was, I'm supposed to be getting a new microphone, and maybe the sound quality is not good, but, you know, we're improving things. We're definitely going to improve on some of the things that has, been going on, and hopefully that, you know, we can make sure that we get it right. You know, we definitely want to get it right, because what you guys listen to is important. And we want to make sure that we bring you the most important things and the most important information and the most important topics that we can. I want to end this by saying there's a lot of people I want to thank out there. I want to thank everyone that listens. I want to thank everyone that tunes in. I want to thank you for taking the time to pick up this podcast and just listen to, like I can say this, a damn fool that kind of like, you know, just comes in and talks about sports. Don't talk about anything else. Talk about sports. Talk about television. Talk about General Hospital. But a good damn fool that does what he likes to do. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. There's so many people out there. You know, I like to thank my staff, Caden Guru, for doing his thing. And I'm still proud of you. Dante Guru for, you know, his thing, doing his thing. And I'm proud of you too, even though that we won't see a Raiders Super Bowl this year. And I still got that clip of you making that prediction, but I'm not going to play it because, believe me, it hurts me every time I have to hear it as well. I want to make sure that everyone out there, you guys have a good, safe holiday. Make sure that you do the right things and stay safe. Go through the particulars I want to say now. YouTube, find me the Guru of Sports Show on YouTube and check that out. Subscribe and, you know, just click likes and everything. That'll be cool. I really appreciate it if you do. Facebook, I'm on Guru's Briscoe. That is the Facebook page of the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. Find me on Instagram at the Guru Talking Sports _ podcast. You can find me on Spreaker. Spreaker is the main vessel that we come out of. Spotify, Podchasers, wherever you find your podcast, that's where we're at. iTunes, iHeartRadio, and like I said, you know, the main ones. I want to thank Miss Mary Mack. Mary Mack has been a very, very great friend. And like I said, I really support her. I believe in her. I believe in her projects. And I definitely would, you know, like to have her on this year. Have her on. I was on her podcast a little while back, so I want to return the favor and invite her in, and she can come on anytime. That's the thing with my guests, with my the people that I talk to, people that come on are always welcome back, and they're always friend of this podcast, and they're always welcome, and I always make sure that I have time for them whenever they want to come in. Jeff Duarte, Cali Sports News, we appreciate you. And like I said, anytime you want to come back on, you're welcome. My cousin Curtis and his grandson Jared, the Young GM podcast, we were supposed to hook up a while back, but I don't know. I'm not sure. Hopefully, you know, I know that it's been rough for your boys out there, but you know, you can come on anytime. We'll be here. My man, Dave May Jr., once again, I want to thank you for everything, for always, you know, being gracious with your time. And I respect your time, and I really respect you. And I thank you for being able just to have a fellow Yellow Jacket that I can go to that knows baseball, which I can sit down and talk about at all times. And like I said, we're going to have a baseball preview again this year. And like I said, he'll be on again for baseball. And, you know, when, like Vince Scully says, when the crack of the bat sounds, it's time for Dodger baseball. It's time for baseball. Thank you for Ray Guru, always musical engineer. Thank you for always your time as well. We really appreciate it. Dante Guru, appreciate you. Voice actress lady, you know, I really, really appreciate you, and thank you for your contribution, contributing to this podcast, and making sure that we grow this podcast as much as we can. And with your cuts that you've given us, I appreciate it. I really do. And I appreciate your time as well. And Cousin Aaron, once again, I want to say rest in peace. And thank you for, you know, the driving force behind me to make sure that this is a great podcast. You know, hopefully it is. But in the short time that we spent together on this podcast, you really made an impact on me, and I thank you. This has been a Black Goat production for Black Goat Sports. Copyright 2023. It's the first time I get to say 2023. All rights reserved. We don't hate. We always congratulate. We celebrate. And we don't steal from anybody. And thank you for the doors, for opening up with Peace Frog. Always. And use the hashtag Big Props and hashtag Guru Talking Sports Podcast. We'll be back next week. And like I said, we always, always make sure that we have a good rapport with our fans, with everyone out there. Thank you. Thank you once again. I'm like really speechless right now because, like I said, I just want to make sure that you guys know that we appreciate you. We're going to wrap it up with some Gary Glitter. Hey. We'll be back next week. A little bit earlier, maybe on a Saturday night. Never know. But I'm going to be on vacation, and I'm going to make sure that I take some time to say thank you for all the things that you do. Hands getting really loud right now. I like this. I like the way we end in a show like this. So you guys take care. Enjoy yourself. Be safe. Enjoy the rest of your football Sunday, your sports weekend. Happy New Year from the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. We will see you next week with episode 148. Later.